Very good evening. Today I want to explain about the switch case. See, if you observe here, switch case in the Mindstorm. See, what is a switch case and why we need to use this one? What are the applications? I mean, where we can use this one? Today I'm going to explain about this one. See, in regular C language or else Java language, switch case is used for the selecting the different cases like if condition. How you are checking the if condition? Same way we are using like a switch. If the condition is the case switch, you can write it here. And in this one, if the case equal to 1, you can do the case equal to 0, you can do the this task, and case equal to 1, you can do the this task. Like that, you will do it in the normal programming. Here, if it is a 0, then you can implement the code in the case 0 block. Okay, so if it is the value is 1, suppose it will come to 1, case 1, and it will execute the code in the case 1 block. Suppose if you write it here like a move forward 2 rotations, move 2 rotations forward, if you write it here. Okay, here if you write it the move backward 2 rotations. Move 2 rotations backward, if you write it like this. So what will happen if you pass the, it will come and it will check it out. What is the condition here? It is a 1. So it will give, it will go to case 1 and it will execute this one. Okay, this is a switch case. Same as if you take the conditions. Okay, one more condition block, if you take it. Here condition block is there. What is the condition block? If you can give some condition, like a greater than 10. If you give it this value, if this is true, then whatever the code you are writing here, that code will be executed. Suppose if you give the else block, okay, when it will be execute, this condition is false, then it will come to here and it will execute the this block. So here, before this one, if you give it here a value equal to 5, okay. Suppose if you give it like this, now see here, it will come to here a equal to 5. Now it will come to here 5 is greater than 10. Is it true? No, 5 is actually less than 10. It is false. So this block will be not execute this one, and else block will be execute this one. Okay, so here we need to check the conditions like this. In these conditions, say actually what is the conditions? If the condition is true, okay, if the condition is true, then only it will execute. Based on condition, it will perform the action. We can say based on the condition status, it will perform the action. So now we will see in the EV3 Mindstorm. Now come to here, I'm going to EV3 Mindstorm. Here I'm taking a new project. In this project, I can keep as a conditions. My project name I'm keeping as a conditions. Conditions I'm keeping here. So where to go means here you can go to control, there switch case is there. You can take it out the switch case. Okay, once you take the switch case, it will be like a normal block only, but it has the options like this. So here if you observe here, you can give the port number. See, first of all, see how many types of switch cases are there. See, in the switch cases, all the looping, test, logic, numeric is there. So there is no count. Okay, in the loop, it is only count also there. But here except count, remaining all things are here. So that means we can check the brick statuses, colors, gyro, sensor. These all are the sensor thing. And this is the NXT thing. And this is a Bluetooth text login like that. Okay, everything we can check it out. In the our presumed value or else our predicted value or else actual value is same. Okay, then we are going to execute. Okay, now see here. Now if I want to use the some sensor, okay, or else if I want to use the some brick buttons. Suppose if every block have the two things. The things are measure and compare. Okay, what is the measure and what is the compare? If you see, measure means the value is not already there. Okay, we didn't take before, now we are measuring what is the value, that is the measure. Okay, compare means already we are giving some value. Okay, so with that value, at present value we are measuring. Like suppose before this one, how I did it like this, in this one if you observe here already a equal to 5 I gave it here. Okay, so already some value I am giving here, so with that value I am checking, so then it is called compare. Okay, compare I am checking. So what I am doing here now, already some value is there, I am giving the value and checking. Now what is the measure? Measure means there is no value, just now only we are measuring the value, like that. You should remember that one. Now come to our programming. Here you can see, so every sensor have different states. So when sensor topic is coming, at the time I will explain about sensors. At present today I am going to explain, take the brick sensor, brick buttons. Okay, brick buttons I am going to compare, because here now which button you want to press it. See, already when we are taking the compare, we need to give the value before only. So that's why I am giving the value like a middle button. When you press the middle button, okay, when you press the middle button, so middle button I am selecting, where is the middle button? Here I am selecting the middle button. So what is the status? When you press the middle button, or else bumped or else released. So I am taking the bump pressed state. Okay, it is true. Then what I want to do, just I want to do move forward one rotation. Suppose if it is false, I want to do move backward to 50 rotations. Okay, now I keep the this one like this. So now what is the program meaning? You can see when I play this programming, what will happen? Actually it will come here and it will check it out. Okay, what I taken? Brick buttons. Okay, for brick button then you know it of port. Any external motor, any external sensor you connected, then only port required. If you want check, you can see here. Suppose if I check the color sensor, immediately the port number will be asking here. Suppose compare color, if I keep it here, automatically the port number is coming, because the sensor we are adding externally. So if you want to see inbuilt thing, so no need of port number. Okay, directly we can go. Now brick buttons. In the brick button, what is this one? This is the which button you want to press it. Left button, right button, a down button, up button, all buttons are there. Even no button also pressing is nothing also there. Okay, so I am checking the middle button. What is the position? If I press that button, okay, so it is going forward. If I didn't press it, it is going backward. If I download this program, what will happen? Can you predict that one? Actually what will happen, see, if I just run the program, it will go backward, because when you are running, you need to press the button, middle button. If you press and keep and play the this one, then it will go forward. Okay, this way it is working. Whenever switch case is coming, you should remember one thing. So the control is coming here, okay, and it is checking the condition. If the condition is true, it will go on, it will execute this block. If the condition is false, it will come and it will execute this block, and the control is coming here, and after that close the program. That's it. But if you want to check it out your switch case repeatedly, so what you need to do, always put in the for our block. So you want to check it out your condition many times, or else every 5 seconds or every 10 seconds, if you want to check it out, you can put in the infinite loop. So the switch case and for our loop will be always use very carefully. Okay, and one more thing I want to note it down here, one more point I want to explain to you. Whenever, especially in the looping, okay, especially in the looping, suppose if you give here one rotation, okay, until one rotation it will not go to end. But if you keep here on button, if you keep here on button, so what will happen, you know, once it will come, so on means actually it is a infinite loop. Infinite means continuously it should be work, but it should not be happen like that. So what will happen actually, so every 0. Yeah, whenever you are using the unlimited block, it will check any block is there or not next. Okay, So it will every 0.1 second it will come out from the that block and it will check it out. What is the next block status? Based on the next block status, it will work. Suppose here next block status also infinite. So infinite time it will work. Okay. Suppose if you put it here, like a some timer, time indicator. If you put it just 5 seconds only, it will check it out like that. Okay. Now I'm using the unlimited. Now what is my point? Why switch case is using? Why we are using the switch case means for checking the status or checking the condition. If the condition is true, then it will go to upside and it will execute this block. If the condition is false, it will come to downside. It will execute this block. Okay. So this is the small thing about the switch case. Whenever you are using the switch case, don't forget to unlimited. If you didn't use the unlimited, so what will happen? Suppose if you forget the unlimited, what will happen? Just it will execute one time only. One time means either true or false it will check. If it is a true, it will execute and close the program. If it is a false, it will come here, it will execute the program, just close the program. But many of students are just they are doing mistake here only. Not mistake, actually they're forgetting about the infinite loop. Simply they will put the switch case, they will check it out, and after that what they will say, sir, it is not working, like that they will say. So whenever you are checking the condition or some program, you need to check it from here. Okay, what I did it, this is the play button. So after play button, the control is coming to here. So after coming here, so it is going to here. The condition is true, then it is going here. The condition is false, it is coming here. So after that, the condition is coming here, like this, like that it will go. Okay, we need to check the flow of control. Then if any mistakes are there, easily we can recognize. Okay, and this is about the switch case and a for loop, and I will meet in the next session.